Humans know a lot. We know how to communicate, how to cook, how to fly. We know about life smaller than we can see and stars bigger than we can ever imagine. But humans also know nothing. In the grand scheme of things, we're just tiny advanced monkeys building things to suit our needs on a small rock hurtling through endless nothingness. We live in a universe full of unanswerable questions. Why are we here? When did time begin? Is there a life after death? Do we have free will, or is everything predestined? Is Earth alive? Why should anything exist? One question that is constantly running around my head that I know for sure we will never have the answer to is, what exists outside of the universe? It's a question that'll make your brain hurt if you think about it for too long. The universe is all that there is. It's everything. So to imagine something other than everything that isn't nothing will have you just running in circles. First, we have to define the universe. One common definition is what we call the observable universe, and this is defined by the speed of light. Since we can only see things when the light they emit or reflects reaches us, we can't really see farther than the farthest distance light can travel in the time that the universe has existed. That means that the universe is getting bigger, but it's also finite. This is referred to as the Hubble Volume, after the telescope that has given us the most distant views of the universe. We will never be able to see beyond that boundary, so for all intended purposes, it's the only universe we'll ever be able to interact with. I can hear you already saying, Jayus, you're confusing me. Just tell me what's outside of the universe. And you know I can't, but fortunately, there are people who are a lot smarter than you or me that have come up with some theories about what might lie beyond everything, and I'm gonna go over them because I find this stuff interesting. One theory is that outside of the observable universe is just more universe. We know for certain that there is more universe beyond what we can see, which is kind of terrifying because we can see a whole lot. The farther you go, the more there is. Other stars, planets, and galaxies. Eventually, you'll go far enough to see everything. Just let that sink in. Everything. Imagine everything. Everything means an identical Earth in every way, except the only difference is you chose to eat eggs one morning instead of cereal before school when you were 12. Another where you lived in the exact same house that you do now, except it's across the street. Another where you became a serial killer, and another where you were killed by one. Another where you were born another gender, and one where you weren't born at all. Actually, an infinite number of worlds where you just weren't born at all. Everything means everything, and infinity is way bigger than the infinity you're thinking of. So to imagine that, and to imagine something bigger than that, and then bigger than that, is just disturbing. This is different from the idea of multiverses, which is a common misconception. Parallel universes is one of the more popular theories about what lies outside of the universe. There are tons of theories about parallel universes, but the most accepted one these days involves an evolution of ideas of string theory to involve membranes that vibrate in another dimension. Yeah, you heard me right. This idea is way past what I can confidently talk about in this video, but a basic rundown of the whole thing is that these rippling membranes in the 11th dimension are whole other universes, and when the ripples slam into each other, they form a new universe. The effects of this rippling motion help explain the observed distribution of matter in our universe. One of the weirdest elements of this theory is the idea that all the gravity we experience here in our universe is actually leaking in from another universe in another dimension, which explains why the gravity we see here is so weak compared to other fundamental forces. One theory brought up by physicist Lee Smolin, known as the Fukunt Universe theory, suggests that every black hole in our universe causes the formation of a new universe. Think of the movie Planet 51 starring Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Tell us your invasion plans, and don't bother taking over my mind. If you do, Captain Kisno has orders to shoot me. If you take over Captain Kisno's mind, Lieutenant Groit has orders to shoot him. If you take over Lieutenant Groit's mind, Sergeant York will shoot Captain Kisno, Lieutenant Groit, and myself. Along with these three soldiers. Each man has a designated target in the squad. Should you succeed in taking over all our minds, Corporal Hisk has orders to electrocute everyone. If this fails, the entire base is rigged to blow at the touch of a button.
Each new universe will have slightly different physical laws than the Forerunner universe. In this way, Smolin suggests a sort of natural selection for universes. As laws that lead to the frequent formation of black holes lead to the creation of more universes, non-black hole forming universes will just die out. In 2008, astronomers discovered galactic clusters that were streaming in the same direction, going over 2 million miles an hour. In 2010, they confirmed this phenomenon and called it dark flow. These movements defined all predictions about the distribution of mass throughout the universe after the Big Bang. One possible cause is massive structures outside of the Hubble Volume exerting gravitational influence. This would mean that the structure outside of the infinite universe beyond our view isn't uniform. As for the structures themselves, they could literally be anything, from aggregations of matter and energy on scales we could barely imagine, to bizarre warps funneling gravitational forces from another universe. Another theory is that after the Big Bang, there were these huge expansions of the universe called bubbles. Each bubble is an area that stopped stretching along with the rest of space and formed its own universe with its own laws. In this scenario, space is infinite, and each bubble is also infinite, because you can store an infinite number of infinities inside of a single infinity. Even if you could somehow breach the boundaries of our bubble, the space in between the bubbles is still expanding, so you would never actually get to the next bubble no matter how fast you went. Possibly the most logical theory about what lies outside of the universe is that there is literally nothing outside of the universe. The universe is all that there is. It's all that exists. Everything that exists is inside of the universe, so the idea of something outside of everything is impossible. According to our measurements of the cosmic microwave background, we determined that the mass content universe is not enough for the universe to be closed. Instead, the universe is both spatially flat and infinite in extent, which means by definition, nothing can be outside of it. The universe is everywhere, and everywhere is the universe, and the whole ensemble is entirely self-contained. Outside the universe is a bit paradoxical, as the universe is supposed to encompass everything that exists everywhere. What confuses a lot of people is the idea that the universe is expanding, but not in the normal type of expansion. Unlike a balloon expanding, this is called metric expansion, which means that the distance itself is getting bigger. The idea that the universe isn't expanding into anything, it's not getting bigger in any sense that you would normally think about. Rather, the universe is hypothesized to be infinite in size, and all of the distances between the objects is increasing without the universe becoming itself larger. Since nothing can be larger than infinite, this balloon analogy only works if you make it clear that the universe is representing the surface of the balloon, not the interior, but nobody ever does that. With this theory, if you were to take a super fast spaceship and fly a straight line towards the edge of the universe, you would end up exactly where you started, because there is no real edge of the universe. All these ideas are wildly insane and scary, and if there is anything outside of the universe, it's probably unlike anything we've ever seen, and we'll more likely never see it. But who cares? To quote one of my favorite YouTubers, "Nothing means anything, and we're all gonna die." Whoa! Thanks for sticking with me as I picked up the pieces of my shattered existential crisis, guys. Hope you all enjoyed that. I haven't made a video like this in a fat minute, mostly because it's harder to edit and I'm lazy. But if you guys like this content over what I've been posting, please just let me know so I can deliver. If you enjoyed this video, please drop a like, and down in the comment section, leave a comment. Where else should we comment stuff? Leave a comment about what theories you like about the outside of the universe, and if you have any questions, leave those down there too, because I love the attention. I'll probably respond. I've been editing for like 8 hours. I'm so fucking tired, you guys. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe. Thank you all for watching, my lovely people. I will see you next week.